black people. It's all about the unity. There's nothing they can do with us, so ain't nobody moving.
That I don't see. What can you learn from a bum, Omar? Shamsuddin? What I learned from a bum, maybe it's what not to do.
Nobody takes down Angel Snuff Nuff 7 easy. There's a reason why, after 100 channels destroyed, Angel Snuff Nuff 7 is still here. There's a reason why nobody wanna get in a beef with Angel Snuff Nuff 7. But you don't take me seriously.
Touch this.
See, they say that Angel Snuff Nuff 7 don't care about the people. But Angel Snuff Nuff 7 cares about the people because I'm bold enough to tell you the truth, and I don't give a damn if you give me a dime. I'm not looking for your money.
Emergency. Prejudice. Wrote a song about it. Like to hear it? Here it go.
Free your mind.
Peace forever and always.
My black people, it's all about the unity. There's nothing they can do with us, so ain't nobody moving.
Yes. I want that. Oh, I need that. Got to have that. It's mine.
I can't describe all the joy that
I love. I
always, 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 always.
I love my
things. I love my things.
yes. I want that. Oh, I need that. Gots to have that. It's me.
Emergency.
Prejudice.
Wrote a song about it? Like to hear it? Here it go.
Free your mind.
What, dear?
Because I keeps it real like that.
I keeps it real.
You know, I was wondering, you know, if you...
Nothing they can do with us, so ain't nobody moving me. Like Jackie King, we make it plain and simple.
Dragon knowledge, empire, and reality's temple. Reality's temple. My black people, it's all about the unity. There's nothing they can do with us, so ain't nobody moving me. Like the king, we make it plain and simple. Bringing knowledge, empire.
I wanna talk to
you. I know who the enemy is.
I wanna talk
to you. You're wasting your time making mockery of me. Oh, I'm crazy. My brain is damaged. My Invo poster. I'm miserable in my life. All this nonsense that you talk about. And you a slave, just like me, in a racist nation.
And interested in black people, let us sit down and find out how we can get together in one direction against one enemy and accomplish this job overnight.
When soul singer and black activist Sam Cooke wrote the lyrics to his song, A Change Is Gonna Come, it was very direct and to the point. With some changes to it, the song was still digestible. In the year 2019, black folks continue to go through the change rather than direct the change. A community activist named Talik Ibn Rod has made an appeal similar to what Sam Cooke was asking for. A change. It's said that the meek shall inherit the earth. We ask when. When will the landlords give the meek a free lease? Mr. Ibn Rod is humbly asking for the state of Mississippi. This is Dusty Basement Studios, and we approve of this message.
The Mississippi campaign represents everything that you claim that you want. The beginning of an all-black independent nation, the ability to control your own resources, your politics, the law, be able to do your own thing for a change, create an economy, create and produce goods that Africa or anybody on the planet would want. You're fake, you don't want to do nothing. 3 hours talking about the Mississippi campaign. Of Islam should evolve into what we call
the Reality's Temple on Earth. You don't need no Arab hand-me-down religion. You don't even need God. You don't need these things. That's good for us in our infancy, in our immaturity, when we was babies. But as we grow and mature, and even in religion itself, it says that we are the children of God. Children can't stay children forever. Children must become adults. So if we are the children of God, that means we become God. Act like God, move like God, and have the responsibility of a God. This is imagination. This is imagination. This is imagination. This is imagination. Operation Action's Mississippi campaign is the most realistic, the best option that we have. And so the troll is jealous because we can stand strong and we can stand firm and we can feel confident that this can work.
Well,
this is imagination. 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 If you say that I'm divine and I'm a prophet, where the hell did your ass go to? Why aren't you heeding the call? Why aren't you helping me get this message across? Since I'm a prophet, since I'm divine. Some people, excuse the language, some people just like talking out their ass. That's what they like to do.
The Reality Temple on Earth.
Shout out to the Reality Temple on Earth on IG.
We love watching it.
Yeah, we really do.
We send love, peace, and soul. Good evening, soul brothers and sisters. This is Tangi Cox, the Black Sheep. And I am propositioning you to entertain just a little while of being in reality. And this is going to hurt soul sisters and brothers because a lot of us cannot accept reality. I empower you to, for 1 year, to subscribe to the Reality Temple on Earth. And at the end of 12 months, draw your conclusion of what have you learned in that amount of time. I empower you. You will never, ever, ever think, feel, or entertain nonsense ever again, period. I would like to see my soul sisters and brothers awaken. This requires time. You need to spend about a year watching, researching, and looking. The Reality Temple on Earth is life-changing, and I stand on that.
Let's get this party started. Ride, ride, ride. Let's get this party started quickly. Let's get this party started quickly. Let's get this party started. Ride, ride, ride. Let's get this party started. Ride, ride, ride. Let's get this party started quickly. Let's get this party started quickly. Let's get this party started. Ride, ride, ride. Let's get this party started. Ride, ride, ride. Let's get this. Let's get this party started quickly. Let's get this party started.
Ride, ride, ride. Let's get this party started. Ride, ride, ride.
Let's get this party started quickly.
Sherry, it's so good to see you. Thanks for dropping in. When you get a chance, look up Soul Liberation Day, December 7th. Oh, that's right around the corner, the transformation. Bless up. Bless up. Thank you for that. Let's see. Talik says, can you send a shout out to my platform, the Realities Temple on Earth Internet Ministry? Our theme this year is After Purge Comes the Heal. Stuff. Shout out to your platform, Talik. All the best to you guys with continuing to stretch in perspective, to stretch in what is possible, and to continue to bring healing into the space of yourself and others. Yes.
Game begins in 3, 2, 1.
All right, Saturday. How we doing? Saturday. This is our day. It's Saturday. And I welcome you to get on board the Soul Train. Yes. Yes, indeedy. Okay. I'm a little sleepy. I wake up. Shout out to the chat room. Shout out to Dickens of Reality. I saw in the chat room, of course, our regulars. Mellow Cap, Twin Pyramids, Soul Brother 85, the mighty, mighty MD20. Those who are listening, shout out to our Facebook listeners and Instagram. Much appreciated. And we just want to talk a little bit. All right. This edition of the Realities Temple is sponsored by Magic Shade. How we want to get this talk started. Well, first of all, I didn't know whether or not to broadcast today. Also, sponsored by Gillette, the best a man can get. I really didn't know whether or not I wanted to live stream this afternoon because a little birdie told me, tweet, tweet, a little birdie told me you cannot live stream solo. I have to go and find some guests. I got to go find somebody to be with me. That's what the little birdie told me. Now, for 15 years, and in the beginning of YouTube, you could not bring guests on your platform. There was no live streaming. So, 2008, I was solo. 2009, I was solo. From 2007 till about 2017, I was solo. And consistent. Solo. There are those who believe because they was here that for some reason they brought the platform more views or whatever. I don't know what it is. I can't tell. No, what you brought was problems. That's what you brought. What you brought was your evil. What you brought was your insanity. What you brought was a bunch of problems. That's what you brought. You didn't bring nothing good. You brought your deception and your nastiness and your profanity. That's what you brought. And so now we are so peaceful. It's so much better that you now have gone away. But you really haven't gone away because there are those who still wish to keep my name in their mouth. And clearly we're not interested. But that's how you get your views. Your views come from profane behavior and nastiness. You have nothing to teach. You have nothing to give nobody. What you have is plagiarism. And whatever you get, you parrot from somebody. Let's flame the chat room up with some parrots. Ah, the Quran say. Ah, the Bible say. Ah, the Honorable Minister Louis Farrakhan. Ah, the Hebrew Israelites. The Moore Science Temple. You don't have nothing to bring to nobody except parroting, plagiarism, copying. You are a human Xerox machine. That's what you are. And I'm supposed to be impressed when for 15 years I don't do that. I very rarely talk the news. I'm not CNN. I'm not Fox. I'm not Entertainment Tonight. That's what they do. They get from the news and other media. That's what they do. I don't do it. For 15 years. So we should be proud of ourselves. You have all this wisdom. And you research and you get the information. Not from yourself. It's not self-discovery. We got the parrots flaming up. Let me give these parrots some shine. Because that's what they do. They parrots. Squawking and barking. That's not my fault you're a parrot. I don't do that here. The MD20 is in the chat room. Told them he's been listening to me since 2010. The only source is me. I might reference, quote from the Quran now and then in the Bible, and we might talk about something in the news now and then. This is the reality's tip on earth. You talk about God. If you have a connection to God, that means you should have a connection to the universe. So if you have a connection to God, the universe, why are you a parrot? Talking about what somebody said in 5,000 years ago, 1930. Somebody's supposed to be impressed because you're a copy machine. I don't do that. I don't need that. Do we need that? Do we want that? Redundant, revised, rehashed, microwave oven wisdom. I don't want that. I want fresh food. Whether I agree with you or not, I want fresh food. I want to hear something new. Women don't have clone babies. Women have brand new life. An individual life. There will only be one. There's only one Angel Snuff Nup 7. When I'm gone, there is no other. There's only one Twin Pyramid, Mello, MD, Almond Delight. There's only one. Once we are gone, there is no more. We are special and we are unique and we are brand new. Women don't regurgitate babies. Each life is brand new. I don't want to come out here because I know myself. I don't even know if I could have really hung being an entertainer because I don't like redundancy. I don't like the same thing over and over again. Now, these ladies here been singing the same song for over 30 years. I don't know if I could do that. I don't know if I could do that because I just redundancy, it irks me. I don't want to see a movie. I don't want to hear a song just over and over again. I heard that. What you got new? I don't really like country music. But I start listening to some country music because I just got tired of the R&B and the rap music. It's old in it. So I start listening to some country music. Start listening to some classical music. Beethoven or some stuff. This is our generation. This is our time. And we respect and we honor those who came before us, but that's not who we are. Who are you? There are Michael Jackson impersonators. But who are you? If you can imitate Michael Jackson, clearly you have some kind of talent. But we don't know who you are because you busy and you want to impersonate Michael Jackson. Instead of discovering who you are. Because if you can imitate Michael Jackson and you can dance like that and you can sing like that, what is your potential? What can you do? But we'll never know because you want to copy Michael Jackson. So out here, we're dealing with people who want to be Marcus Garvey. They want to be Malcolm X. They want to be Muhammad Ali. They want to be Jesus. They want to be everything except themselves. So we supposed to be impressed by you, and you're nothing but a copy. You're nothing but a clone. I need somebody to come here and be with me. To say what? To say what? What you heard on the news? A book you read? I want to hear something fresh. I want to hear something new. You have to look inside yourself. You have to discover yourself. What do you bring to the table? If you can't bring nothing to the table, you might as well sit your ass down. Because there's a lot of clones out here. There's nobody like us. And I like it that way. So I'm happy to walk by myself. unless, of course, there's somebody else worthy who have found themselves that can bring us something fresh. What they talking about on these channels? I don't even know anymore. I unsubscribe to all of them. They have nothing. The same hash, microwave oven, rewarm stuff that we've been hearing for the last 100 years. I can't do it no more. A bunch of, I'm trying to be smart. And you are smart. And you are intelligent. To those who are impressed by your regurgitation, by your redundancy, by your cloning and your parroting. Exactly. We want something fresh with no preservatives. There's nothing like fresh food. Most people have given a choice. You would rather have your food fresh. Not out of a can, not microwave. You want your food fresh, fresh out the garden. You can grow your own vegetables. The fresher it is, the better it is. But when it comes to your religion, when it comes to your ideology, rewarm, rehashed, revised. It makes no sense. And if that is spiritual food, then you're doing your brain a disservice. There's an old saying in the Nation of Islam when it comes to the fruit of Islam. A fruit is fast moving, quick thinking, right down to the modern times. And I still carry that with me. Fast moving, quick thinking, right down to the modern times. I'm trying to stay physically fast moving. I'm trying to. Trying to watch my weight, trying to physically continue to be fast moving. Quick thinking. We should want to be that. There's so many slow people on social media. And they want to argue and debate. You think too slow and make it so bad. Your teachers and your ideology is rehashed, rewarmed. So all you have to do is repeat. It's not like you have to bring something new. You're bringing something new to the table. But they still slow in the mind. Fast moving, quick thinking. Right down to the modern time. What is the modern time? Is it 5,000 years ago? 3,000 years ago? 1847? 1927? 1968? 1978? Fast moving, quick thinking, right down to the modern time. How the hell you're going to be in 2023 still talking about 5,000 years ago, 1930, 1920. That's not the modern times. So this is why, even though the Nation of Islam, under Louis Farrakhan or any of the factions of Nation of Islam theology in 2023, you cannot progress. You cannot move because you're still stuck in 1930. And this is 2023. You're saying the same thing, doing the same thing that they did in 1930. you are not down to the modern time. In fact, you cannot even accomplish what it did in 1930, 1960. You can't even accomplish that. We cannot accomplish what slaves who could not read, could not write, many of them, we cannot even accomplish what they done fresh off the slave plantation, who spoke broken English. Many of y'all, you went to school and you speak proper English. Oh, it's not pronounced that way. It's not have it, it's have not. You must speak proper English. And your proper ass is still a slave. You are properly still on the slave plantation. Nothing has changed except the form of slavery. The slave master could go out in the field and grab a black woman and have his way. In 2023, still can do it. They still do it. You still do the work for Massa. He give you a little chump change, and you still on the slave plantation. You make no laws. You control nothing. You just here, like the slave was. You just here. Here to do what? Benefit your massa. And you spit out all these children that don't benefit you. They benefit others. And you keep spitting them out. Do you know why? You keep spitting. Well, for some of us, that's the only way you can feel like a man or a woman. By having a child. Now you feel like a man. Hey, MD, I'm expecting my first child. Have a cigar. I'm a real man now. Matter of fact, I got a baby by her and her and her. They all expecting at the same time. I'm a man now. And the females don't feel as though they are a woman till they spit out a baby.
As a woman now, I got the baby. Look at my baby. Let's have a baby shower.
And you and her don't produce baby shoes. You don't have to produce baby milk, but you have to because she's ashamed to put her baby, or she can't afford to put her baby on her breast because she got to go to work. Because y'all want to live the high life. But you don't feel nothing. You don't feel there's nothing wrong with that. And you feel like you're a man. You go out to your car. You don't produce no gas. You didn't build the car. You didn't get the rubber or the steel. I'm a man. I'm a man. I'm a father. And everything that you give your child, you didn't produce. You work a job and buy the products from somebody else. You don't produce nothing. You're proud of that. And you still want somebody to call you a man. I'm not. So you can take your happy ass on somewhere else. I'm not going to call us no man. And you don't produce the necessities for your children that you spit out. If you could produce and enjoy the pleasure of producing the way you enjoyed the pleasure of producing that baby, we'd be on top of the world. But you don't. That's too much like work. We should feel proud. To produce the things that we need. This is the purpose of the Mississippi campaign. To give you an opportunity to produce something for yourself that all of us can benefit. So our children, we could take control of organic food. And our little baby said, you eating that tomato or you drinking that organic milk, chances are we produce that. Our children have nothing to brag about. That's what we want to talk about today. Our children. We want to talk about the youth. I shouldn't talk at all because I need somebody to be on a panel with me. Otherwise, I'm not worthy of nobody listening to. But we've been here for 15 years, from 2007 to 2017. At least 10 years, there was no panel. There was nobody here to help me to do anything. What the hell do I need you now for? I don't need you. I don't need nobody. I don't need nobody to sit here with me so they can bring their regurgitation. Well, I was reading this book. I saw a video. I don't want to hear that crap. I can watch the same video. I can read the same damn book. What are you going to bring to the table fresh from your mind? What is your connection to the universe? What is the connection to your soul? I don't need nobody here. We much better off. And so we did bring certain guests or whatever. And you got to put your head like this, basically. I mean, they might be saying something cool, whatever, but it's like same old, same old. I got this from a book. I was watching a video. I was watching the news. We don't self-discover nothing. Why do we have a brain? Might as well take the brain out your head, out your skull. You know, it's worthless. It's useless. During the 15 years that I've been here, I've been called, even though I talk the way I talk, I have been called a prophet. I have been called a messenger. Called that. But apparently they didn't believe that. Apparently they didn't believe it. I was called that. But see, look. Somebody was telling me about the miracles of Jesus. And the miracle of the teachings of the Honorable Elijah Muhammad. That's fine. And then I tell them. Let's compare our miracles. In a couple of months, it would be 3 years, I was diagnosed with cancer. 3 years. No treatment, no medicine, no pills, no nothing. I'm ready to die. Bring it. I'm talking to death. Come get me. Take me, punk. 3 years ago. The doctor gonna tell me. And I knew it was bad news when the doctor came. I'm sorry to inform you, but you have cancer. And I'm like, well, whatever. How much time I got? Because usually when you're told you have a cancer diagnosis, chances are you're in big trouble. They looked at me like I'm insane because I don't care. My loved ones, my relatives is more concerned than me. I don't care. I didn't tell my audience about it. I just kept doing what I do. And I did do a little chemotherapy. I let that stuff go. That's more death than the cancer. I probably died from the chemotherapy than the damn cancer itself. You didn't know. You knew I had a surgery. And most of you probably didn't even pay attention that I look different. Because when you do that chemotherapy crap, it takes the glow out your skin. And I lost all my eyelashes, all your hair fall off, all that crazy stuff. And you probably wonder, look different. I didn't tell you. But then I guess it was meant for me to tell you or for you to know because a traitor in my camp decided to tell the world. And then, of course, my worst enemy found out. I told you was going to die. I told you was going to die. I cursed you with death since 2013. I curse you with death since 2013. This is 2023, 10 years ago. Three years carrying cancer in April. So they're going to tell me about the miracle of Jesus. And he gonna tell me about the miracle of Elijah Muhammad. Let me tell you about my miracle. You're looking at somebody going on 3 years, no treatment for cancer, no medicine, no pain, no nothing. 3 years. Can your miracle top my miracle? And my miracle is not a belief. My miracle is 1,000% facts. I went to Dr. Wednesday. The cancer continued. And on Saturday, I'm on my live stream running my damn mouth in a white shirt with my favorite ladies behind me. With cancer. Say hello to the people, cancer. Hey, how y'all doing out there in YouTube land? I'm just cancer. I'm just traveling with Talik for a little while. Don't worry about a thing. You don't know what you got. So the same way that you can brag what Jesus do in the miracles, what Elijah Muhammad done for me. I could say the same thing, except mine is real. It's actual facts. And you didn't hear it from me first. You heard it from my enemies first. The traitors first. The slanderers and the gossip people first. In a way, I guess that it was good. Because it verifies what I stand for and my self-appointed mission. No God, no alien, my self-appointed mission, because it's time. It's time for us to push all this garbage to the side. Religion, spirituality, all this pro-blackness stuff, it's a hindrance not only to the development of soul brothers and sisters, it's a hindrance to humanity itself. It's time for it to leave. It's time for it to exit. It has to be time. When I can stand before you and come before you with cancer, almost 3 years straight, and talk to you, I'm not in no pain. I'm not suffering. Never have. I did live streams from my hospital bed with two dominoes. You gonna tell me about the miracle of Jesus? I'm telling you about the miracle and the power and the will of your brain and who and what you are. I'm an example of reality. The human body can repair itself if you give that body a chance. It's not miraculous. I'm not drinking no green juice. Well, brother, you need to drink some. I haven't drank no green juice. I haven't done nothing. I don't drink no alkaline water. I don't pray. I don't do a damn thing. So bring your God here. And bring your spiritual realm here. And they can't explain it. The doctors don't understand. You're not in any pain. You're not suffering. They don't understand. How can you carry cancer like that? I'm very sure they probably want to do a study. They wondering, how is this possible? It's possible because it's time for all this nonsense needs to be pushed away. And if you can talk about your miracles and this power of your God, then I can talk. I'll go one step further. I'm going to tell you that your God is backing me up to show you that what I'm telling you is right. Your God has given me the power to live. Now, how you like that? Because according to your belief system, nothing happens without God's permission. I asked God to kill me. The week of December the 7th, I told God to kill me. I asked and prayed for your God to kill me. The week of December the 7th, Soul Liberation Day 2020, I asked your God to kill me because I didn't want to taint you. I don't want to say nothing to lead nobody astray. And the God kept me here. Louis Farrakhan has cancer, been fighting cancer for many years. He never made a speech from his hospital bed, to my knowledge, with tubes all down his throat, because he said he's in pain. I made live streams in my hospital bed with tubes down my throat. And they took me off pain medication. They was like, why waste it? This Negro ain't in pain. Save the insurance company some money. Am I bragging? No, I'm just telling you the facts. And you see the facts right before your eyes. You don't know what you got. I'm saying to us that the Mississippi campaign, I'm saying to us that the Reality Temple on Earth mindset is the direction where we need to go. If you don't do it, and this is your last chance, I'm the real final call. You want to keep laughing, giggling, and you don't want to take nothing serious. I'm the final call. I'm a miracle right in front of your face. Everything you got should be into spreading this and pushing this. Everything. It's your last chance. I'm the final call. Nobody else has nothing. It was two men supposed to come here on the live stream. They're not going to show up. They know what they're facing. They don't want to show up. This religion and spirituality and this pro-black Pan-African stuff, these teachings and ideology, is darkness. It's darkness. When we are children, when we are embryo, we are in the darkness. But in order to live, you got to come into the light. So they keep telling us all this black stuff. Black is darkness. It represents darkness. We have to come into the light. Light, life. Light means life. I'm black. Black is darkness. You in a cave, meaning you're blind and you can't see. I'm black. I'm the can't see people. I'm the blind. I'm the Batman people. You're living in a cave. You love Kemet. You're living in a cave. All these different stuff that we believe in. You're in a cave. In darkness, you become a racist just like the people that whoop you. Like a lot of women now, they call themselves B's and H's because men have been calling them that for generations, and now they brag about it. I'm a bad B, I'm a bad, I'm a H with an attitude. Now you become what they made you voluntarily. It's time now that we come into the light. Over 100 channels terminated. And you crying. What does that say about us? 2021, the channels got terminated. And they was laughing. Huh? How long did they laugh? The other channels just started slowly rising right back, came back to where we are. Even the channels with nothing still get the same amount of views as the channel that had 1,000, 2,000 subscribers on it. So what did you do? You didn't hurt nobody. And they cried. How much did we cry? How many times did I come here crying about, oh, they said this and slandering the God? The only thing we did was present our evidence to counter what was said or whatever and kept rolling. Truth speaks for itself. You don't have to explain. You don't have to ball out. I went to court with this fat pig. I don't have to say nothing. Just let the truth speak. I sit and chill. They are upset. Right now. I'm not upset. How are you going to be upset when you know that you stand on the truth? You don't have to be upset like that. You get upset because you are a liar. And you see that your lies fall apart. So where are all these people at? All these people you recruited, all of them are gone. And you're lonely trying to continue your filth from a year or so ago. We are stronger and better than that. Go ahead and rewarm and rehash and revise and regurgitate your mess. There's no need for me to do that because I'm connected to the God you claim that you connected to. I'm saying your God, whether it's the Hebrew Israelite God or the Muslim God or whatever, God stand with me, not you. You don't know nothing about me like that. I can accept my wrongdoing. I come on here and I tell people about how I've messed up in life. I've told people about that. I have no problem with that. I have no problem with saying I'm sorry and offering an apology, but I'm not going to do that. And you're not going to force me to do something that I did not do. I'm not doing that. I've done nothing. We've done nothing to none of these suckers. You don't want my friendship. You don't like how I talk on this platform. Take your happy ass on somewhere. Just because you're not here has not changed nothing. You mean nothing to me. You mean nothing to us. Take your savage Fred Flintstone Wilma ass on somewhere. cave people, man people, eating rewarm food, microwave oven food. Time reveals. You have no respect for time. Time reveals. A slave has no use for time, because time, his time belongs to his master. So what do a slave need to understand and respect time for? And we still have the same mindset right now to this day. You have no respect for time. Time reveals all things. It was time to get rid of those people. Because I could have backed down. I could have handled things a little differently. For what? It was time to get rid of them. And you were sick of them. It was time. It was time to get rid of all them folks. You were sick of them. Time for them to go. Another thing about time is time expires. So we had a brother here, African nationalist, whatever he called himself. And I asked him, well, you already had 100 years, bro. Well, we're working on the next 100 years. Who's to say you have another 100 years? See, a slave mind don't have any respect for time. We working on our second 100 years. You didn't do nothing with the first 100 years. You don't deserve it. You have not earned the right to have another 100 years. They don't like that type of talk. They don't like that type of talk. You cannot, how can I say we need to push religion and spirituality and all this pro-blackness, pan-African stuff to the side? How can I do that without some kind of intelligence? I got to have some kind of intelligence. And no respect for our intelligence. And we are quick moving, fast thinking, right down to the modern time. I have to have incredible intelligence to challenge Nation of Islam teachings, Hebrew Israelite teachings, spirituality, Pan-Africanism, all these isms, all this stuff that we believe in. I can't come out here, don't do the Pan-African stuff, cause I can't come like that. I gotta come strong. These people have been around for 50, 100 years. So here I am, a Johnny Clately, and I have the nerve to challenge. Woo! It reminds me of the Bible. Because when Jesus makes his appearance, there was already religion, types of beliefs already established. And here comes Johnny Come Lately, this Jesus guy, telling these people, that ain't how you're supposed to do it. That ain't how, what? It's the same thing with me. It's the same thing with me. I'm the Johnny Come Lately. You gonna tell me Elijah Muhammad was wrong? You gonna tell me Noah Ali is wrong? No, that's not what we're saying. We're saying they served their time. This is a different time. We have to do things differently. A new mindset, a new strategy. But the slave don't want to leave the plantation. You left the physical plantation, but your happy ass loved the mental plantation. And that's why you don't understand the realities of Temple Earth, because we're trying to understand and learn how to be free people and not a slave. You don't act and you don't behave like free people. You just want to go from one slave plantation, from Massa Thomas plantation, to Massa McGregor's plantation. Because the grass is greener on the other side. But when you examine religion, spirituality, all this pro-blackness and pan-Africanism, the grass is not greener. They have a slave master mentality too. They don't believe in equality. They talk about it. They don't believe in equality. I mean, look how things are set up around these people. They don't believe in equality. They don't believe in humanity. It's all about me. The same as these people. They just want to be the ones who kick ass. They want to be the ones, they want to be the slave owners. They have the same mentality as the ones they complain about. So, I'm a Johnny Come Lately. I can't just come out here diddly getting along, la 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 di da. I gotta be ready. And since 2007, I've made some changes, got rid of some things or whatever. But we damn sure ready in 2023. When we came up with the Mississippi campaign, that was the frosting on the cake. Because they always said, well, what you gonna do? What you got? Here it is. We have to change our mindset. We have to change the way we look at things and do things. And pass that down to the children. We're damaged goods. But since we know better, we got to do better by the future generations. Something simple as stop cursing and allowing our children to listen to profanity and filthy music. That would help us a whole lot. Something simple as that. Stop smoking cigarettes in front of the children and drinking alcohol in front of the children and dancing these filthy dances in front of the children. We have adults, mostly women. I've seen some men too. You can be on TikTok and some of these short, what they call real videos, and they got their children and they twerking and their butt in front of the camera. You are outright savage. Somebody did a side-by-side with a supposed to be savage primitive people, and they put us in the club right next to it. You couldn't tell the difference. What was the difference? Matter of fact, you nasty. You're nastier than the so-called primitive people are. You doing you getting drunk and you smoking your weed and you doing your drugs and your filthy mouth. But we expect something better from the children, and that's who you are. So I have to be intelligent. I have to be on a level to challenge all these things. Tariq Nasheed is a smart man. Sonetta is a smart man. Young Pharaoh is a smart man. The Honorable Minister Louis Farrakhan is a smart man. I can't be no loser. I can't be no chump to get in the ring with these people. I gotta come hard. I gotta come strong. I'm the new kid on the block. How it was when Mike Tyson first got into boxing. New kid on the block. You have all these other people, they've been boxing and whatever. Here, Mike Tyson, he thinks he's going to come and be champion overnight. Mike had to come in there and knock out a few people real quick. And that's what we do here at the Reality's Temple. You get in the ring with me, I'm a new kid on the block, but I'm going to knock your block off. Intellectually, I'm fast moving, quick thinking, right down to the modern times. You can't do nothing with me. It's proven. 15 years proven. We knock them all out the box. You don't want none of this. Your best bet is to be friends and work with us than against us. You don't have nothing coming. Getting upset, being angry, so what? That's childish stuff, having temper tantrum. So I have to be intelligent. One thing they don't like about your Snuff Nub 7, they don't like how I defend the sisters, and this is not to say that the sisters are perfect or they're angels. Because our women, our sisters, that would not be true. However, as a gender, before you run your mouth and talk, get your gender together. Straighten up these men. Take care of yourself first. You are a coward to attack women. You are a coward when you don't challenge the men that's kicking your ass every day. But you can attack women and children and old people. The elders didn't do this, and the elders, that's over with. If you live long enough, you're gonna be an elder too. What the hell you gonna do? And some of them same people I heard back in the day, the elders didn't do this, and the elders didn't do that. Here they are, crossing 45, 50, 55. Just a few years ago. The elders, now you are elder. And what have they done? What have they done? They complain about the elders. What can you do? Situation is worse. Oh, I know what you do. You come on YouTube and Make a YouTube video. That's what you do. And pretend to be smart. You have all these people out here, they pretend to be smart. They want to try to impress you because I read a lot of books. I stopped reading books. The reason why I stopped reading books, because these books that I was reading do not help you in real life. They don't help you in real life. Theology, philosophy, and all that stuff, they don't help you in real life. You want to read a book? Learn how to repair a car. Learn how to sew. Learn how to garden. Learn the law. Learn the law, basic law. Real information. Would Dr. John Henry Clark say, and Mark, that's not going to help you in real life. Go to jail and tell the prosecutor, well, Marcus Garvey, all these Moorish Americans don't know the law. Getting pulled over, getting shot and killed, go to jail over dumb stuff. They don't know, just copying and plagiarizing somebody. I'm a Moorish American. What country is that? Is Black Sun still in the house? Black Sun, what country is Moorish American? What country is that? I'm a Moorish American. This is my ground. According to who? Let me tell you something. Once you get your ass whooped, and somebody kick you off the land, you don't own it no more. When you get carjacked, you no longer own the car no more. Somebody pull a gun, give me your car or your life, you get out because you say you can have that damn car. They own the car now. You will not own the car again until the police find it with no tires and no radio, no gas tank and all that kind of good stuff. Now you can have it. It's yours. It's yours now. You own it again. We don't even own our life. Any piece of ass came off the street with a knife, with a gun, or even with their bare hands, and they can take our life. We don't even own our life. So we own, you know, we don't own nothing. This my land. I'm a Moorish American. Not only if you cannot defend the land, if you cannot enforce the laws that you make in that land, you don't have nothing coming. It's simple as that. It's simple as that. We all into this nonsense. Oh, the white man, they owe us reparations. Reparation is not a debt. They don't owe you nothing. All you reparations people out there, they don't owe you nothing. Reparations is not a debt. Reparations come from those people who have enough empathy in their heart to say, look, we made a mess here and we want to try to repair it. So we want to try to heal the hurt that we caused. Reparations is not a debt. If it's a debt, go get your money then. Go to small claims court. Go to civil court. File a lawsuit. It's a debt. Give it to the debt collector. Get your money. It's not a debt. These people, if they really wanted to, they could kick all of us out of this country. Kick all of us African Americans out so they can make room from the people from Brazil and the Ukraine or whatever, if they really wanted to. Ain't a damn thing you could do about it. They couldn't do that. Yes, what you mean they couldn't do? Yes, they could. What you gonna do about it? They have drones, they have tanks, they have everything they need to round up all the African Americans that they find and kick all of us out the country. Because look, these Negroes talking this crap. You want to go to Africa? Go, whatever you want to do, you got to get the hell out of here. And one day, and we said that on this platform, one day it could be true, because you never know what might happen in the world, and it could be true. We sick of these Hebrew Israelites. We are sick of these Pan Africans. We are sick of all these people talking about the white man's the devil. We're kicking all y'all ass out. And people are like, oh, I said nothing. And plus, I'm old too. Don't kick poor Oprah out. You know you love me. Okay, we gonna keep Oprah. We gonna keep Oprah and Gail. Never gonna get it. So you talk all that bull until your whole card is pulled. I'm gonna go to Africa. Here you are in a country calling these people devils and cracker and all this. We're gonna kick all of y'all. Sick of you calling us cracker and peck of wood and devils, and get all you happy ass out of here. And these Hebrew Israelites talk about God gonna come and make space out of us. They sick of all that kind of talk. Let me show you what we gonna do. Not God. Let me show you what we gonna do. We're gonna take our military, we're gonna take the National Guard, we're gonna take our helicopters, and we're kicking all you African Americans out, and we're gonna destroy your history in our country like you've never been here before. That's what we're gonna do. Now, how you like that? Tell Allah that. Tell Yahweh bin Yahweh that. Tell Elijah Muhammad and Allah, Master Farah Muhammad. Tell all y'all God's. Tell all that to that. While you out on a boat going to your country or wherever the hell, because you ain't gonna be here. And Mexico gonna say, don't be coming to our borders. Canada gonna be waiting on you. Don't come to our borders. I'm gonna tell you, Africa don't want you either. All these Pan-Africans talking to us, Africans gonna say, you can't come now. Don't come to our country. Y'all live in the fairy tales. Fairy tales and fantasy. They don't like me. They don't like to hear that kind of talk. See, men, if you was really thinking like a free man, if the possibility is there, then you have to be ready for it. And you're not. Because you're just a happy slave on Massa Plantation. La 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 la. I'm going to make me a YouTube video. La la la, I'm a vegetarian. La 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 la. Comfortable. I'm gonna go get me some poutine. La 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 la. Yeah, and I want me some ding tang. La 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 la. Until they show up on your doorstep one day, like they did Jewish people in the 1930s. And start round you up. What y'all want? Got to get on the black bus. Prison bus. You going to concentration camps, detainment centers. And some of y'all even talk that way, but you're not doing nothing. You're not getting ready for it. The possibility. Because you don't know what to do. You don't know what to do. It's like, it's like running around here knowing somebody's trying to kill you. And you're living life, la 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 la, all hunky dory, la 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 la. Hey man, somebody trying to murder you. Oh, that's all right. They might miss. La 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 la. You don't believe it can happen. Like the young girl, she couldn't believe she could get pregnant. She doing what you're pregnant. Can't happen to me. That happened to somebody else. Can't happen to me. Then she ended up pregnant. And her family feels shame, teenage pregnancy. Again. So my position is, as men, we have to straighten up our own gender before we can talk about women. But see, this is the thing. You straighten up the men, and I guarantee you don't have to worry about the women. They're going to automatically follow your lead, follow your example. I guarantee you, you don't have to worry about them. Because they're gonna watch your transformation for the better. What if, guys, they're not like what they was. They're gonna change with you. Because we're all the same. We are all connected. And we supposed to be the strength. We supposed to be the leaders. That's what y'all say, right? We're supposed to be the leaders. We're supposed to be the strength. Well, act like it then. Folks gonna get upset with me because I made a post. I was watching this documentary about primitive African tribes. And when I was watching the documentary, I noticed they are self-sufficient. They produce everything they need. But when it comes to us, we want to call ourselves alpha males, and we want to call ourselves gods and men or whatever, fathers. That's not the case with us. We're not self-sufficient. Those people, those men in primitive tribes, they're not begging nobody for water. They're able to get their own water. They made their own houses, their own clothes. Not begging nobody for nothing. But we here in America, we do. We're not making shirts and ties, baby milk, tires for our cars. We're not doing those things. So how are you going to get angry at Angel Snubnub 7 for talking about the obvious? And it's true. You don't act and you don't behave like a free man. You produce none of the necessities of life. You like to get drunk. You're not even producing your own liquor. Now, you did produce some crack for a while there. it did produce crack for a while. but you don't produce none of the necessities of life. You have to pay utility bills to another man. And those utility companies are worth trillions of dollars, billions and trillions of dollars. These utility companies that provide gas and lights, and electricity and water. So every glass of water that goes in your child's mouth, you paid for it, but you didn't produce it. And you don't think there's a problem with that? You can't even get a drink of a glass of water for yourself? You get angry and upset with Angel Snub 7 because I'm just talking obvious. You don't want to accept responsibility and hold yourself accountable for getting a glass of water. But you want the praise and the honor and the credit for being a man, but can't give your child a glass of water. So time reveals these things. I'm on time. See, your problem is when you come messing with Angel Snub 7, I'm fast moving, quick thinking, right down to the modern time. What got me to where I'm at right now? Well, in high school, not the Nation of Islam, it started in high school. We had debate class. And we learned how to debate. We were so good, we came in second in the state in the debating class thing. I've been trying to get that videotape, one of the shows that we was on. I can't get 1979 or something like that. I think it was 1979. I'm trying to get that tape. I would like to see that again. And then when I went into the Nation of Islam, and I wanted to preach the teachings of the Honorable Elijah Muhammad, I was put in ministry class, and you have to learn how to defend the teachings of the Honorable Elijah Muhammad. And then I went to the crazy house, and I learned the law. And when you go to court, you basically are debating why this person should go to jail, why this person shouldn't go to jail. It's debating. So all my life, the very beginning was when I had to learn how to debate my sisters because I didn't want to hurt them. I had to learn how to talk with them instead of like y'all do. You get violent and angry because you're not fast thinking. You're slow with it. So you turn to violence because you don't have no intelligence. And you're slow with it. And when people that can think fast and quick, it messes with your mind. So the only thing you know how to do is become violent because you're slow in the mind. And this is a great majority of the people on social media, slow in the mind. They're not fast, not quick. Even though they're repeating the same redundant, revised garbage, they still slow. What I supposed to say now? MD, what I supposed to say now? So I become good at this thing here. But the main thing is, I don't care how quick-wit you are, how charismatic you are. It all means nothing if your argument is weak. So whatever you bring It has to be logical. Belief, spirituality, and religion, and a lot of these pro-black teachings or whatever, it's basically belief. So you're going to have a weak argument. That's why you can't do nothing with Angel Snub Number 7, because we want to bring facts to the best of our ability. And belief is not going to be able to stand up against facts. It's just not going to do it. I don't care how, like when we was on Tahaka Bay's live stream, he tried to paint it up like this and try to paint it up all pretty, you know, manufacture this and try to bring science and mathematics. If you believe, sir, it's a weak argument. It's still a weak argument. Let me play this video so you can have an understanding of what real debate is. Y'all got some time? We almost done here. I want to show you how real debate goes. How it's supposed to go, how it's supposed to sound. This is an excerpt from the movie with Denzel Washington called The Great Debaters.
Resolved. Child labor should be regulated by the federal government. The first debater argues the affirmative. Second debate, it means that you are what?
A gangster.
Brilliant, Ms. Burgess.
The book.
Book.
With an E.
Arise, Miss Book. With an E. Into the book. E.
You know, there's never been a female on the debating team, ever.
Yes, I know that.
First.
Because,
discourage hard work. You'll argue the negative.
Alright.
Welfare takes away a man's strongest reason for working, which is survival. And that weakens the will of the poor. How would you rebut that, Miss Book? With an E?
I would say it does not. Most of the New Deal goes to children anyway, and to the handicapped, and to old people.
Is that fact or conjecture?
It is a fact.
What's your source?
The President.
Of the United States?
Yes, sir.
That's your primary source. You spoke to President Roosevelt personally.
Of course not. I did not speak to him personally, but I listened to his fireside chat.
Oh, a radio broadcast.
Yes.
Any other sources?
Yes, there are other sources. Like that look in a mother's eyes when she came. And feed her kids. Without welfare, Mr. Tolson, people would be starving.
Who's starving, Miss Book?
The unemployed.
Mr. Book here, he's unemployed. Obviously, he's not starving.
You gave a faulty premise, so your syllogism fell apart.
Syllogism?
Your logic fell apart. Major premise, Mr. Burgess is unemployed. Conclusion, Mr. Burgess is starving. Your major premise was based on a faulty assumption. Classic fallacy. Who's next?
Young lady. James, I just want to thank you.
For what?
Well, for your performance tonight. I mean, how many other students ever stand up to Tolson?
I did.
No, you answered a question and I spouted a few quotes. Miss Book, with an E. She fought back. Jones. Why isn't a fireside chat a legitimate source? Nobody has better access to this than the president. Now, if you'd have called Tolson on that, you'd have won.
I don't know. I'm sure that man would have come up with something.
Good night, James.
1 week.
That's right.
I thought Prairie View was first.
Prairie View was tough, so I thought we needed a warm-up.
With the best Negro college in the state?
That's right, Mr. Burgess. Does that frighten you?
Yes, sir.
1 week's not enough time to write our arguments.
You do the research, I'll write the arguments.
You write the arguments.
And you deliver them, Mr. Lowe.
What the hell do I look like, a mailman?
Hell is where you're headed if you question me again. In theory, you look like a student.
So what you're saying is I'm not capable.
It's not a matter of confidence. It's a matter of experience.
Well, how do I know you write better than
I? I write the arguments. That's the way it's been. That's the way it's going to be. Any more questions?
Resolved. Unemployment relief should be ended. When the depression ends.
If the depression ends.
I traveled back through history to 1536, when the first poor laws of England were mandated. In those days, the dole, or welfare as we call it, was funded by voluntary contributions. But as time passed, the English devised the allowance system, the first unemployment relief. Now it was paid with their economy. More common owns taxes. The allowance system was a disaster. The only real unemployment relief is to give a man a job. But to do that, you have to give the economy life, not tax it to death.
When capitalism was young, the old puritanical concept of duty was, he who does not work shall not eat. Now that made sense when it was more work than men willing to do it. But those days are gone. People today, we need a new concept of duty. The right of the individual to demand from society just as much as he gives to society.
We clutch at anything that even looks like a solution. Pay it out. Hold the streets. 1/7 of the population of the United States on welfare. Fine, as long as it ends our misery. A nation as desperate as this is a danger to itself.
Once, a Roman general brought peace to a rebellious province by killing all its citizens. Even his fellow Romans were shocked. One of them wrote, "Solitudinem falsiant, pacem appellant," which means they create desolation and call it peace. Now, for all their facts and figures, the Paul Quinn debaters would also create desolation and call it peace. They would allow the unemployed to die so the economy can live. A brilliant young woman I know was asked once to support her argument in favor of the welfare. She named the most powerful source imaginable. The look in a mother's children. Can you look that hungry child in the eyes? See the blood on his feet from walking barefoot in the cotton fields? Or do you ask his baby sister with her belly swollen from hunger if she cares about her daddy's work ethic?
He's good.
I like that movie. The Great Debaters. Now, we have on YouTube these different debate stuff, different debate clubs or whatever. Don't sound nothing like that. A lot of times they want to debate, or most of the time they are debating belief systems, belief ideologies, different philosophy, ideology, or whatever. And when you're dealing, you're really wasting your time dealing with those things based in belief, because they contain a lot of illogical points. It's founded upon those things which makes no sense. How are you going to debate something that makes no sense? No matter how you try to twist it and flip it, if it makes no sense, you can't make it make sense if it makes no sense. It just don't work. That's what belief is about. So that's why it's called belief. I'm going to believe, hoping that it do make sense one day, which don't make any don't make any sense. Woo! Oh, wow. I was just thinking, I'm almost 60 years old now. And do you know we barely miss slavery? I caught the butt end of Jim Crow, which was 100 years. My mother lived in Jim Crow for about 30 some years. My grandmother lived in Jim Crow. And my great-grandmother, it was a possibility she was a slave, or her mother was a slave. We're really not that far from physical slavery. We act like we've been free, we've been happy-go-lucky for a long, long time, and it really hasn't been a long, long time. Actual physical slaves were still alive in the 1930s. My great-great-grandmama's mama might have been a slave. And I was still born on a plantation. I was born on a plantation where they had slaves. The plantation where I was born was so large, it had its own zip code. I thought it was a town. I just recently found out, no, that's a plantation. Had its own little stores and crap on the property. It was a plantation. So I was born on a plantation. But slavery, of course, was outlawed by the time I was born. I was still born on a plantation where there were slaves. We're not that far. When Marcus Garvey was here, actual physical slaves were still alive. The last known child of a physical slave died in 2002. We're not that from the plantation. And so I'm looking at our history. And I see that we are, this generation, we're a bunch of ingrates. And we barely missed the plantation ourselves. We are a bunch of ingrates. We take things for granted. It's all about fun. Having a good time. Dancing, singing, smoking, sexing. It's all about fun. But see, our ancestors, afford to have fun. Everything about their existence was really, really serious. Because you make the wrong move, and you could end up lynched. And contrary to popular belief, Black people still was killing Black people in those days too, over bull crap, like we do today. Slaves was killing slaves on the plantation. Slaves was killing, Black people was killing Black people when we got free. It wasn't always the white man. Matter of fact, if you Black, you can kill a Black person and lynch them, and they'll blame the white man. You don't think that happened? Because we would do that right now, today. But we live in an atmosphere where we are very ungrateful, we're ingrates, and we don't appreciate what we have. We barely missed the whip. We barely missed the chains. I heard Minister Louis Farrakhan say years ago, and see, time reveals. This is not Angel Snuff's opinion. This is not my belief. Time reveals. The things that I bring to this platform is obvious. Time reveal. Minister Louis Farrakhan said in a speech years ago, and he's been saying this for a while, white man scared of our young people. These young people aren't like us. They warriors. They fighters. They're not like us. So the white man got to give them drugs and alcohol and pornography and do everything to keep them calm down because they warriors. They're not like us. That's what he said. On the cover, and I've seen this for a few times, on the cover of Ebony magazine, and some of you probably have seen this yourself also, they talk about the 100 future leaders, Black leaders, young people of tomorrow. Well, that tomorrow is today. And many of these younger people are probably in their 30s, early 30s, early 40s or whatever. Don't get mad. Well, you can. I can take it. I can take it. Whatever they throw at me, I can take it. It's quite obvious. This generation, what have they done? The warriors. Well, they twerk on YouTube and they twerk on Facebook. That's what the warriors are doing. They are getting tattoos and they're bleaching their skin. They're getting tattoos, smoking more weed and doing more drugs, spitting out a whole bunch of babies they can't afford. Trying to get rich and hoard all the wealth that they can. One of the things that they love to say is, "I gotta get paid." That's their favorite phrase. Give me my bag. I got to get paid. That's on their mind. Give me a MTV award. Give me a Grammy. Come to my church. I'm a big shot preacher now. The Warriors. One of them is Snoop Doggy Dogg. What do Snoop Dogg? Snoop Doggy Dogg actually supports Minister Louis Farrakhan and all like that. What do Snoop Dogg, Snoop Doggy Dogg still advocate smoke weed? Snoop Doggy Dogg still advocate calling women H and B's. That's your warriors, and that's your warriors in the future. That's what they do. The 100 future leaders, what have they, what do they do? Leading what? Because some of them might be a CEO somewhere in a Fortune 500. It's not theirs. They got a nice position at Google. Hope you don't get laid off, because Google and Microsoft and all these suckers, they were showing off their money. Now things is getting tight. Now they laying off all these people in the tech fields, hundreds of tens of thousands of them getting laid off. That's what these corporations do. When things are going good, they hire people they don't need because they just want to look. Well, we have 100,000 employees, and they do stuff like that. Then when the money stopped rolling in like it was, then it's time, what they say, last fired, first fired, last hired, whatever, and you got to go. Wish you good luck. You might get a piece of a severance pay or whatever. That's how they do. You know, some of these leaders in the future, they might be a great rapper now or whatever. They've done nothing. This generation of warriors, and they've done nothing. So Louis Farrakhan prophecy, his claim that the white man is scared. Well, here's their excuse. Well, that's because they've been drinking liquor and watching the pornography. The bad old white man been doing all these things. We don't want to hold ourselves responsible for anything. You like to drink. You like to smoke weed. You like watching porn. You like Netflix. You like YouTube and Facebook. Nobody on here is being forced to do drugs, drink alcohol, or none of the things that we do. Then you turn around and make fun of Christians because the Christians say, well, the devil made me do it. And you saying the same thing, except you replace the devil with the white man. Well, the white man make all these movies and whatever. We don't want to hold ourselves responsible for nothing. We don't want to hold ourselves accountable for nothing. Are we really dumb herd animals? We really stupid? They've been saying the same thing. Well, the white people do this and the white people do that. Well, since you know that they do that, why are you still falling for the trick? No, because you like it. Because you like it. Just say it. Just say you like it. You like to get drunk. And some brothers and sisters will tell you. I heard, what's that actress? Lisa Ray. Lisa Ray, I heard her say, I like to get drunk and screw. That's what she said. That's what I like. Now, she's an actress. Some of you have probably seen her on stage, screen, and whatever. And that's what she said. She said, I saw some of her reality show, and she said, I like to get drunk and screw. And that's what we are. We like to get drunk. We like to scream, like to party. We like to party. And y'all righteous people, you party in a different manner. You want to go listen to your favorite preacher. Oh, praise is due to Allah for the honorable Elijah Muhammad. Oh, praise is due to Allah for, I like to party. I like to party. What difference? What difference? Is it? It's the same thing. What's the difference between all praise is due to Allah, I'm Elijah Muhammad. Then I like to party. I like to party. They get drunk on drugs and alcohol, and you get drunk on the spiritual teaching. You both of you still drunk out your goddamn mind. So what difference do it make? You like to party. How can we expect you people to do different when we are their example? If we are partiers and we are drunks and reefer smokers, that's what we produce. Nat Turner was a rarity. Harriet Tubman was a rarity because the majority of the people was content being a slave. If they wasn't content, they couldn't even be a slave. There's an animal called a zebra. They tried to domesticate the zebra. A zebra looks like a horse. And they tried to domesticate the zebra. The problem with a zebra is a zebra will make you think everything is fine. And next thing you know, they'll buck you off and kick you in your head. They'll pretend like a zebra will pretend like you broke the zebra like they do a horse. But a zebra can't be broken. A zebra will pretend and catch you off guard and kick you and kill you. They was like, oh, no. We're going to leave them zebras alone. I can't do that with the zebra. But a horse, you can break the horse, break the spirit, the will of the horse. And you have a horse, you have a slave for life. The reason why our ancestors was chosen as slaves because we was easily broken. If we put up a fight, you can't make a slave out of you, you can't trust it. Slaves didn't wear chains 24 hours a day. They was free. Free to pick up an axe, free to pick up or get a gun. They was free. They wasn't in chains 24 hours a day. You can't work out in the field with chains like that out in the fields. But once you broke them, they're a slave for life. They wasn't trying to run away. They wasn't locked up in the slave quarters. They could run away anytime they felt like it. But they was broken. You gonna talk about people supposed to be warriors? We don't know about no warrior. We don't have no warrior spirit. We don't have a warrior spirit. How are these children going to have a warrior spirit and we don't? We don't have a warrior spirit. The closest we ever came to it was the 1960s. And those children, young people, rose up. But their children didn't. Because Massa understood what it would take in order to make them docile again. Give them some more cornbread. Give them some more pork chops and some black-eyed peas or something. Give Andrew Young a cabinet position. You know, pacify them. and we are still pacified. And look at us, how we want to live. Louis Farrakhan is not a warrior. He wants to live silk sheets, gold chandeliers, comfortable. What kind, when you're thinking about a revolutionary, revolutionaries are dirty because you're fighting. Soldiers and warriors are fighting. Let's see how those Ukrainian soldiers, what they look like. Are they clean? When was the last time they took a bath? We're too comfortable. I just want to party. And see, you can do that because another man take care of you. You can party. You party for no reason, just for fun. You have the right to party when you act like a free man and a free woman and finally establish the things that you need to provide for your life. You can get your own water. You put money in your pocket that you give value to. You produce a generation of warriors, not because you hope, because that's what you do, that's because you train your children to be that. How are we going to expect the next generation to be warriors? And we don't even guide them in that manner. Because I look at my young relatives, none of them have a warrior spirit. They over showing off their drink, liquor. I just had a baby. I just had a baby. You're warriors. And the beefing. And the young girls don't know who that baby is. It ain't me, the young man. It ain't my baby. I mean, go to TikTok for a few minutes and look at our videos. The Warriors. It's not Angel Snuff number 7. Louis Farrakhan said that the white man was afraid of the next generation of young people because they warriors. Well, go on TikTok, even on YouTube, and look at what the warriors do. And then what are they gonna do? They just be what your ass was doing. All praise are due to Allah. Oh, Jesus, Jesus. You don't know what it means to be a, you know, pimp in the street, a gangster in the street. They are what you are. You're not a warrior. So how the hell the next generation, these young people, how they gonna be warriors when you're not? A cat produce another cat, a bat produce another bat, a dog produce another dog, a warrior will produce a warrior, a clown will produce another clown. And that's what we got. We're clown ass people. Barnum and Bailey. Circus freaks. You want to get angry at Angel Snuff number 7 because that's the obvious. It's obvious. You're a slave, people. And the only thing you can do is produce another damn slave. How you gonna get angry at Angel Snuff number 7? How you gonna reject Operation Exodus Mississippi campaign when That's a method. That's a way that we can become free men and women. A training ground, because we don't know what the hell we're doing. So we're going to use this as a training ground to help us get where we want to go. And we can do trial and error so we don't have to lose a lot while we're learning. And we have a nation that will help us, back us up when we fall. How are you going to get angry at Operation Exodus Mississippi? How the hell are you going to do that? You don't know about leading nothing. Starting your neighborhood. You don't even control your neighborhood. Building a nation. You don't even control your neighborhood, let alone talk about building a nation. That's just talk. You can't even get along with your own people. Oh, you talk about Jesus. I don't like you. You don't like the Honorable Mr. Lewis Fairkin. I don't like you. You don't like to smoke weed. I don't like you. Can't even get along with each other to do a damn thing. Just envious of each other. That never stops. There are people who claim they don't like Angel Snubbing Up 7. But if I was on their side, they would love it. The Nation of Islam would take me back in a heartbeat. I know they would. Easy. The Hebrew Israelites would be happy to have me and the church and the Pan-African. They would love it. But see, I can't do that. Because I have a conscience. I know what I need to say. I know what I need to do in order to get thousands of views and get a lot of donations and money. I know what to do. I have a conscience. Bothers me. I know that's over. I know that it's time for change. And I know what's hindering our movement and our progress are these things trapped in fairy tales and fantasy and these ideologies and spooky. So here we come, a miracle. We got our miracles too. I see them on Facebook trying to explain. You can't explain it. Facts don't need to be explained. I've been carrying cancer for almost 3 years. There's nothing to explain. What is there to explain? It's a fact. You are the one with your beliefs. You have to explain these different things. Well, how God do that? I ain't never seen nobody walk on water. I never seen snakes talk. I never seen birds have babies. I never seen nobody astral project out their body or whatever. I'm still waiting on the person who told me when I go live, they're going to astral project during my live. They haven't showed up yet. I had a person, what's his name? Astral Boo Baby or whatever. We supposed to have been doing a record. Do you remember that? We supposed to have been doing a record together or whatever. He can't handle what I say about spirituality. That's your belief. What do making a record have anything to do with it? That's business. I would pay you. But see, these people are so hateful and nasty. They don't want nothing to do with you because you won't accept their belief. Astro Boo Baby said that Donald Trump was supposed to win the election. He didn't. Donald Trump has to wait till, 2024 to try again. Your prediction was wrong, sir. And there's a lot of people. There are people in the Nation of Islam won't sell me a newspaper if they know me. They won't sell me a newspaper. They won't sell me a bean pie. I don't like the way you talk about the minister. We don't have to do anything. My money is green. Are you selling the pie, the newspaper? See how silly they are? If I was selling Reality's Temple pies, I don't care what you believe in. I don't care about your sexual orientation. I don't care about your gender. I don't give a damn. Bean pie, brother. Thank you very much. Please come again. I hope you enjoy the product. This is how they are. I don't want to work with Minister Farrakhan. But I will work with you, Brother Ben. Yeah, but you said all those things about me. See, stupid stuff. I wanted to buy this very expensive soap. Almost $10 a bar, some kind of organic special soap or whatever. I was just going to buy it just to support the brother. The brother didn't like what I had to say about Islam. I ain't selling you no soap. It's stupid. But from you supposed to produce warriors, and this is how silly. Look, a goat produce a goat, a bear produce a bear, a slave can only produce a slave. This is where the transformation comes in. From Negro to God, we must be trying to change. We're not going to produce no special children or whatever until we are able, till we change ourselves, because we can only produce who, what we are. And you see, we are a bunch of losers and failures. They don't want to hear that either. I got an ice cream shop. I take all the young people bowling every Friday. How does that change? How does that change our condition? What does that do for us? Because you take the young brothers bowling every Friday. What changes our lives is our children to be able to look at us when we become producers of necessities of our lives. So when they take a drink of water, they know their people got the water. Pay our utility company, our power plant, our farms, us, a little something. We're not expected to produce all our necessity, but damn, a little something that we can be proud of so our children can say, that's us. We are in a position, if they were smart, we could take control of the transportation industry. If we had smart leadership, train these young brothers that ain't doing nothing, help them get off the street, let them, if they don't drive, let them be helpers, put them to work. They need about 30,000 truck drivers right now, I believe. This is your time. It's so many things that we could do. Just don't have the leadership. Don't have the leadership. Don't have the visionaries. They just want you to listen to YouTube videos all day and pray to Allah. We are behind. I'm going to say this in conclusion. We are behind. Those things that we do, that's beautiful. I don't want to make mockery. I don't want to degrade anything that people do. That's not what I'm doing. What I'm saying, it's not good enough. We're too far behind. We need something big so that we can be competitive. Your little Roscoe's and Roscoe Waffle House is not big enough. We have to have something that we can work on that can put us in a position to take us, put us, first of all, it would take us, put us, make us able to be competitive and beyond. So you can get the respect of Russia. So you can get the respect of China. So you can get the respect of African nations, if that's what you want. Playing on YouTube don't get you the respect. Those people don't care about you because you support Russia or China or Africa. It's all about what can you bring to the table. When Russia approached Africa, when China approach Africa, is all about what they bring to the table. What can you give me? What I'm going to get in return? You have nothing to offer. How are you going to get when you didn't put nothing into something? That's not how things work. You got to give to get. Most women would tell us that, right, brothers? They, take me to dinner. You can take me to a movie. You got to do something. Even a prostitute, you got to break off. You got to do something. This fairy tale, like something is going to drop off the sky. Your condition is not going to change unless you make it change. You got to deprogram yourself. Let your brain guide you to the solution. It will guide you to Operation Exodus Mississippi campaign. That or something similar. But that's what we need. We need something big. I could have talked about, don't take over a neighborhood. Let's take control of a neighborhood. I could have talked about a city or a little town. No, we need a state. And I didn't talk about the whole South. No, you need to prove that you deserve that. You need to earn that status. Because if you can't take control of a state, what you gonna do with the rest? You setting yourself up for failure. So you can make all your mistakes and you can fall. Because this is your training ground. This is your training wheels. So you can begin to understand what it takes to be a full functioning man, a full functioning woman. And I'm going to say this and we're going to get out of here. If you're not righteous, and this has nothing to do with religion, if you're not righteous, what they call righteous, if we don't begin exhibit moral behavior, this has nothing to do with religion. If you don't exhibit that, might as well leave everything alone. You are fine exactly where you're at, because getting the state really is the easy part. Maintaining, making that state successful is the hard part. It cannot be done unless we begin to exhibit, as they say, the righteous line. And it begins with rituals. We teach each other in the state, everybody. Yes, sir. Go back to the way we was in our neighborhoods. Yes, sir. No, ma'am. Yes, ma'am. Teach the young boys to be a gentleman. Teach our young ladies to be a lady. Respect your elders. Respect your neighbors, because there's always going to be fruitcakes. So as neighbors, we're going to look out for each other against the foul. And we will take care, when we find out that you're foul, we will take care of you. Because you are enemy of the state. You're not going to hurt none of our citizens. Straighten your ass up. Get out of our state. Go to Indiana, Alaska, some damn where. You're not going to act that way. You think the white man was bad on you? Act up here. It's going to be worse. We don't have time for your shenanigans. You're not going to hurt our people here. Take your drugs and your other garbage, your strip club. You go somewhere else with that foolishness. You become a righteous people. You'll take this state to places where you thought you'd never go. And you will begin, other people will want to be like us. How they do that? We want to be like that too. Let us be the leaders. Show people how it's done. Don't preach righteousness. Why you gotta preach righteousness? Because your ass ain't right. That's why. But when you become right, you don't need a Bible no more. You don't need a Quran no more. You need a Bible and a Quran because your ass is not right. You need a crutch. What do I do now? Where the Bible at? It's Jeremiah chapter 5, 7, 8. When you become right, you don't need that no more. When you become a chef, you don't need a recipe no more. It's all up here. You become the recipe. A cook needs a recipe. How many of you have been in the food business? The difference between a chef and a cook, most cooks, they still need to follow a recipe to cook something. When you become a chef, it's all up here. You become the recipe. You ever watch Hell's Kitchen? Some of these cooking shows? These people that know how to cook? You don't see them using measuring cups and spoons and things. They know what they're doing. It's all up here. They become the recipe. Know it by heart. They become that. We want the righteous. And you don't need a book no more, because that's who you are. Don't need it no more. When you can walk, you don't need a crutch. If you got 20/20 vision, you don't need glasses. This is who you are. They even teach that we're supposed to be a righteous people. Well, damn it, be righteous then. That's your problem. Talking about righteous, but you're not. In order to be successful long term, that's the reason why the Nation of Islam failed. That's why Moorish Science Temple, that's why all our organizations, all this stuff, because we're not righteous. Had we been righteous, the success would have been better. You want to be like your oppressors. You want to be like the other people in the world. And they rotten. They disgusting too. Whores. Whoremongers. Dope fiends. Why you want to be like them? Keep talking about Kemet. Kemet don't exist. Is that what you want? Not to exist anymore? This is your time. And everything here is in place for you to take advantage of. I believe it's fishing. I believe it's fishing. And you have to wait for the low tide to gather these mussels or whatever it is. And if you don't go gather the mussels and the high tide comes in, you have to wait to the next cycle. And this is how it is with us. You're not gonna get a better time than right now. These people that you call your enemies, they got much other stuff going on. Nobody paying no attention to the so-called nigger in America. The next time they pay attention to you, on your way to taking control of this state. What, when they do that? How they do that? It's about proper leadership. Where does proper leadership begin? It begins with you, not Angel Snuff number 7. It begins with you because you lead all this. You listen to the wrong suckers that don't know what the hell they're talking about, selling you dreams and fairy tales. They don't know what to do. If they knew what to do, we already be there. They've had plenty of help. Thousands of people help them. And if they're successful, more and more people will help you. They all failed. The Nation of Islam failed. More Science Temple failed. Hebrew Israelites, all the Christian church is a failure. All of it is failure. It served its purpose. It's time for them to move out the way. Another thing, if our children did become warriors, like you're talking about, you're not going to like their moves. Because their moves is going to be different from yours. Because they might really be violent. Or whatever. You might not like their moves. Because they can't be like you. We're not the same. Somebody born in 1989 is not the same as somebody that was born in 1969. Two different time periods. Two different people, generations. You're not the same. Similar, but not the same. An orange is not a grapefruit. They might be similar. They're not thing. So it's on you. I'm here and I want to help you be successful. I don't want your money. I don't want your booty. I don't want nothing from you. I want you to be liberated. I want us to be in a better place. These things need to be revised, or we need something new. I prefer, it's better to just go with something new. You can have your personal beliefs. That's not the problem. The problem is your beliefs and your ideology is hindering you from looking at the situation, the whole situation, so that you can't go forward. Because you're too busy and interested in converting people to your belief. Who gives a damn about your belief? You can believe that all you can believe in a cabbage if you want to. That has nothing to do with what is in the best interest of the whole, the people. That mindset is hindering the people because it's causing you not to unite with your brother and sister for what is in the best interest. You don't have to like Angel Snuffing Up 7. We don't have to like each other. People go to work every day, working for a company. They don't have to like everybody there, but everybody is there to build a car. You don't have to like nobody. The purpose is to build a car. And that's what we're gonna do. You don't have to like nobody. The purpose is we want to liberate the people. We want to be examples of righteous behavior so we can be successful. Has nothing to do with liking somebody. But I guarantee you this, once you begin that process and we work together, finally, and we start seeing success, you're going to find out, hey, Snuffing Up ain't so bad. So-and-so ain't so bad. We are at each other's throats out of frustration, out of denial, and so many things. So we lash out at each other instead of using that energy in order to find the solution in order to progress. How does about Black Sign every day? How does that help us? How does talking about Yanga every day, how does that help us? How does that help you? How does that help you as a person? Except you carry a different kind of cancer and you allow that to keep eating you and eating you. And you're no good to the masses of the people, and you're no good to yourself either. And cancer kills. That's what cancer does. One 100 channels terminated. There's a reason why. They don't want you to hear a non-regurgitated, something fresh, something new message. We need to be transformed. We need to go through a metamorphosis. We can't continue to be who we are right now. We must make a change. And like Brother Michael always said, look at the man in the mirror. It's time to make a change. Can't you see something is wrong? Can't you see something is error? We got to change. We look stupid, keep trying to put a square peg in a round hole. It's not going to go right. We look insane. We've made insanity fair seeming. Mm. Well, on that note, we out of here. I had a good time talking to us. Sometimes we really don't know what we have until we lose it. We really don't. I would suggest to us, I'm not special. I'm just your little brother here. I'm not divine. I'm not spiritual. I'm not nothing great. I'm just your little brother. I went through some things. And my eyes see something different, something wrong. And my mind has come up with a solution. This is what you need to do to solve this problem once and for all. And you don't need 100 years. You're going to see your handiwork in your lifetime. It's not going to take that long. The problem is us. That's the problem. Our selfishness. Our inability to think. We are not quick moving, fast thinking, right down to the modern time. Fast moving, quick thinking, right down to the modern time. We're slow because our minds is clogged up with this cholesterol running through our veins. You're not going to get anywhere. You're not going to get anywhere. And it's quite obvious. Time is real. Not a stunt of seven. I'm just telling you the obvious. But you want to continue to try to do these. No. It's not working, people. You're never going to get it. Terry, where Terry at? You're never going to get it. On that note, let me get out of here. If anybody had a question or a comment or whatever, we want to entertain that before we get out of here. I enjoyed myself on this live stream. I thank you so much for joining us. Me by myself. I don't need nobody with me. I'm fine. I don't need nobody else to handle this business. Now, of course, if they can handle the business, I'll sit back in the cut. Go ahead and go. I don't know nobody else that talk the way I do. They don't see things the way that I do. So we need to take advantage of somebody else's sight. Because black means darkness. We're in the dark. We can't see. Living in a cave. We want to take us out of the cave. Shout out to Facebook, Instagram. I did turn it on. Shout out to those in the listening on Facebook. Those who will be listening to this broadcast at a later time, I thank you so much for joining us this afternoon. I really appreciate you keeping me company. It's wonderful to know that I am not alone. I'm not by myself. And they're so jealous of that. These folks don't want nobody to listen to Angels Not Enough Seven. But okay. So bring something better. You don't have anything better except the same old regurgitated stuff over and over again. Sarah Sunseti don't even try to bring nothing up to date. I was looking at some of the stuff on his channel, and he just strictly 5,000 years ago. You didn't live 5,000 years ago, sir. But and they sit there listening. Yeah, Seti. Go ahead, Seti. What? I mean, what are you saying? What are you applauding? The man lost try to go back in time. Do you think if Kemet was able to continue to flourish, you think they would still be doing what they do, what they did 5,000 years ago? They wouldn't. So we don't want to do that. We are here in the modern times. I'm not going to go back 2,000 years ago. I'm not going to go back to 1960. We're going to stay right here where we at, because this is our time. And the future. Babies are not born in reverse. Babies go forward. They don't go back in time. You as a baby, all of us was baby, push forward into time. It makes no sense. We become adults. Now we want to try to go back to where our mama was at, where our great, they didn't even, it makes no sense. The whole thing is illogical. Well, you're welcome. Shout out to Brother Talib, just joined the conversation. Deacons, Mello, Almond, Delight, MD20, Brother Black Sign came through. I did say Mello. Yeah, Mello. And all those, all our people who will be listening to this broadcast as a, at a later time, of course, shout out to Sister Tangie and Josiah and India, her family there in Los Angeles, our people in London, England, just acting in the resident. We have Brother Denzel, Z-Mad, Razzie Fry, Tafari Smith, Christopher Steffens, Sean Davis, Angela Hines. I think I got everybody. That sound more than 10 subscribers. So we're growing, y'all. Cool. Yeah, on that note, again, I enjoyed our talk. And if the Holy Spirit hits me again, we'll be back here for another spontaneous broadcast. When the Holy Spirit hits me. And I will not wait till tomorrow what I can do today, because as you know, tomorrow is not promised to us. Also, again, if you're interested in my autobiography, you can get that on Amazon. Subscribe to the Deacons of Reality YouTube channel. That's Deacons of Reality YouTube channel. Subscribe to that channel. If you want to donate to this platform, Cash App, Angel Snuffing Up 7, or you can go Zelle. Information is in the description box of all the videos. What else we want to talk about? Subscribe to our Rumble channel. Everything that I do on YouTube, I put on Rumble. Also, I put it on the Facebook. So you can like our Facebook, Realities Temple on Earth Internet Ministry on Facebook. Also, our Rumble channel, Angel Snuffing Up 7 Rumble, and Realities Temple on Earth Rumble. I got so much here that I got to do. It's just so much work. I'm tired. Oh yeah, Phil Fox. I sure did. I miss Phil Fox. Okay, so we got Phil Fox. All right, so I mentioned everybody. I hope I didn't forget our main supporters, because the main supporters, woo, that 2021 Rumble, woo, made it very, very easy for a brother. They still crying, still crying, but they can continue to live in 2021. We're living in 2023, and the soul train moves forward. On that note, We are Audi 5000. In the words of our ancestor, Brother Don Cornelius, we always say, as in parting, we wish us love, peace, and soul. And we are Audi 5000, right? Yeah.
Always in parting, we wish you love, peace, and soul.